How's it going, YouTube? Today I'm going to be showing you guys a quick unboxed look at the Quartermaster Inspector M43 Double Buckle Boots. Now at the time of recording, it's March 2023, and I got these through Hessen Antique for $115. Packaging wasn't anything special, they just shipped in a bag in a regular cardboard box from them. So you won't find anything like you would with at the front boots, but let's go ahead and start taking a look at these. And we'll start with the lower here, which on first appearance, the leather is very soft, rough out. It's very pliable, and it seems to be a chrome tanned leather, especially up here in the cuffs. But the stitching's fairly even throughout, and it seems to be constructed fairly well overall. Seven eyelets for the laces here, and what appears to be a Goodyear welt stitch. It just, for me, it looks like it's for appearance, and the boot's actually made up of a Blake stitch construction to hold the soles on. You don't have any leather midsole here, it's just a colored rubber to make it look like there's a leather midsole, which they got to cut costs somewhere to make these so cheap. One of the things when I was purchasing these boots I was worried about was the Hessen Antique website showed there's no nails in the sole of the boot on their example. You can see the manufacturer there. But we have full nails through the heel bed there and through the arch and at the toe. You can see that stitching's very spaced out along the outside there, and it looked like, as I can think, is a Blake stitch construction. Now looking at the cuff here, the finish isn't great. You can see there's a lot of random cut marks there. The stitching isn't terribly even to the edge. The ends don't match there. The buckles themselves are good. With good rollers, they look about on par with SM Wholesale or at the front. But one of the reviews on that I could find was that the upper cuff here was heavily painted. For me, this is just a flesh without any painting on it, which is nice because it'll take better to dubbing. So that one there, and we'll take a look at this other one here that I got open so we could get a better look inside. Again, the tongue's not the greatest finish. Another review mentioned the tongue's losing the eyelets, and we have one here that's looks like it might come out. You can see the stitching here is just, it's sanded away here, there, and lower here, so we'll see how that works out in time. I might come back and restitch that at some point. But the leather itself does seem to be a very decent quality for what you're paying. You can see on the inside here we have a heavy green canvas. It's flexible, it's not terrible, and it'll certainly loosen up with time. You can see this is the only other tag you can find or stamping or marking on the boot for the size here in the cuff other than what's on the sole. The tongue here, I measured it, it's around 2 millimeters thick, and you can see it's got a good full grain to it. Does have some marks here just from, I guess, the manufacturing process, not sure. Full leather inside, and the insole here is some kind of, it's just a little stack of, we have a fiberboard here, some foam, and a little piece of leather on top, and this is what runs throughout the front to the back of the boot. You can see down in there that Blake stitch construction on what appears to be another fiberboard footbed. Not the best, and that'll certainly wear out with time, and if you plan to get these boots wet, that's going to be something to worry about. You can see the stitching here on the lower is still good, and the eyelets there, they're in there good enough, and it looks like that on both boots. But overall, they don't seem bad for the price at first look. And I'll just show real quick the foot of the boot compared to a M48 original reset boot. You can find a lot more nails throughout the footbed. Same pattern and the mimicked stamping there. The laces that came with the boot seem to be a very heavy untreated cotton. And here's some new old stock ones. You can see they got a lot more shine to them. And on the reset boot here, we can see as well a range of colors. So these are the ones with the QMI, original new old stock. And then these are at the front ones on these reset boots here. So that's it for a quick look at the Quartermaster Inspector boots. And I'll be getting back at some point once I get these dubbed and in use for a little bit. Thanks.